Welcome to the fifth session of managerial economics. We are discussing the first module of managerial economics, that is introduction to managerial economics. And in this topic, if you remember, in the last session we discussed about the relationship between economic variables. We term them in term of linear, non-linear. Then we discuss about that how these variables are related and what is the method to capture the relationship. So one was what we discussed in the last class is slope. Slope is basically, it captures the change in between the dependent variable and the independent variable. But when the change in the independent or the dependent variable is very small, in that case the general method to calculate slope or just finding the relationship through the slope sometimes does not serve the purpose. And that is the reason we introduce the concept of differentiation, and differentiation is a method, differentiation is an approach through which we can calculate the or capture the change in the dependent variable due to change in the independent variable. So in the last class we have taken just a general functional form and identified the differential calculus method. In this class what we'll do, we'll take some different kind of function like constant function, power function, derivative of function of sums and differences of function. Derivative of function is a product of two function, derivative of a quotient and derivative of a function of a function. And also we'll take a function where there are multivariables are there. So we'll just check one by one how the differentiation is generally used, or how the through differentiation how we calculate the relationship between the two different variable, independent and dependent variable, in the different kind of functional form. So we'll start with the constant function, and where if you look at the functional form is y is equal to, it's a function of x. So y is a function of x and which is equal to a. Now what is a over here? A is the constant. Okay. Now if you will take a first order derivative of this functional form, in this case what is the first order derivative? We have to take the derivative with respect to x, and which will come as 0. Why it will come as 0? Because it is a function of x and that is in the form of a constant. And when you are taking the first order derivative with respect to a constant, the derivative, the value of the derivative will be equal to 0. So whatever the value of x, y remain constant here. There is no change in the y, because y is represented in terms of a function and function is a constant over here. So maybe you, if you modify this bit and if you put a value, suppose you take a functional form, y is a function of x and which is equal to 500, this is the value of the intercept, this is not the value of the slope here. So in this case, whatever may be the value of x, there is no change in the y, y remain constant, because this is a derivative of a constant function. Now we will discuss the second kind, the derivative of a power function. Okay, so here the functional form has a power on it. Suppose here again y is the dependent variable, x is the independent variable. It's a, y is a function of x and which may be ax to the power b. Now here there are two constant, one is a, another is b. Okay, so y is a function of x which is ax to the power b, and in this functional form we are getting two points, one is a and second one is b. Now if you take a derivative of this, how this will become, what is the outcome over here? Del y with respect to del x, that will be b a x b minus 1. Okay, now let's give a number to this functional form. Suppose take a functional form where y is equal to 5x cube, so x to the power q. So in this case, y is a function of x and the x has also a power on it. So now what is the derivative or how we can check the relationship? Del y to the power del y with respect to del x. So that will come as the 3, 5, x, 3 minus 1. So this is 15 x square. Similarly, you take one more functional form where y is equal to 4 x square. Okay. Now, how will find the differentiation over here? So, del y by del x is equal to 4, then 2 x 2 minus 1. So, this is 8 x. Okay. Similarly, suppose we take one more functional form which has also a power on it. So, if you look at, suppose we take y is equal to 2x, okay, x to the power 1 over here. Now, if you take del y by del x, then this comes to 1 multiplied by 2 x, then 1 minus 1. So, 2x to the power 0, which is equal to 2. Now, suppose take one more functional form in this category of derivatives, like this is the derivative of a power function. So, let us take y is equal to x. Now, what is del y by del x? Del y by del x is equal to x 1 minus 1, which is equal to 1. Similarly, if you take one more functional form which has a negative power, y is equal to 5x minus 2. So, this is del y by del x minus 2, 5 x minus 2 minus 1, and this comes to minus 10 x minus 3. So, this is how we solve when we get a power function. And what is the significance of this power function? The functional form has a power. So, and it can take any value that is from less than 0 or that may be the greater than 0. Now, we will discuss about the third category of the derivative, that is derivative of a function of some differences of functions. Sometimes if you will find it is not only a single variable, there is also a summation added to it. So, if you take an example where y is a function of x and also it is a g is a function of x. So, y is dependent on this x, function of x, and also function of this x. So, in this case, how we take the derivative? In this case, the derivative is del y by del x is equal to del fx with respect to del x plus del gx with respect to del x. Similarly, now if you give a numerical term to this, suppose we take a functional form y is equal to 5x plus 2x cube. Okay. So, now taking the first order derivative del y by del x is equal to 5x 1 minus 1 plus 2 multiplied by 3x 3 minus 1. So, this comes to 5 plus 6x square. Now, what happens if it is not a case of addition, if it is there is a differences, it is not a sum, rather it is a differences of function. Now, we will take another functional form in order to show that when there is a subtraction or when the y is dependent on x and the functional form has a subtraction, so the functional form has a differences between two variables, how to get the derivatives of this. So, let us take here that y is a function of fx minus gx. Okay. Let us give a numerical value to this. So, y is equal to 5x square minus 2x 4. Taking the first order derivative, del y by del x is equal to 2 5x 2 minus 1 minus 4 2x 4 minus 1. Okay. So, this comes to this comes to 10x minus 8x cube. So it's like if the y is dependent on a function which has the addition or which has the subtraction, in that case we have to take the partial derivative with respect to both the variable. So in this case, like it is fx and in the gx. Now suppose apart from these two variables, let's add a constant also in the functional form. Let's take a functional form where y is equal to 4x cube minus 3x square plus 3. So now how we'll get the derivatives over here? So del y by del x is equal to 3 4x 3 minus 1 minus 2 3x 2 minus 1 plus 0, because the first order derivative of a constant would be always equal to 0. So this comes to 12x square minus 6x. So in case of a derivatives where the function is of sums or the differences, we get the functional form in term of the negative value, like there is a differences between two variable, or there is a positive value, there is a summation between these two variables. Now let's check what is the next kind of a function. So this is a derivative of a function as a product of two function. So in the last case we took care of summation, we took care of the subtraction. Now we'll say that when the derivative of a function where the function is as a product of two function, okay. So in this case, how the functional form will be? The functional form will be y is function of x and gx. So the functional form is product of two function, that is fx and gx. Now how to take the derivative over here? Here we take the derivative keeping others as constant, and in the second part we take the derivative of the second part keeping the first part as the constant. So in this case, this is fx dgx dx plus gx dfx dx, okay. So now let's take a numerical function to get more clarity. Suppose we say that y is equal to 5x square 4x plus 3. So here y is dependent on two function, one is 5x square, second one is 4x plus 3. So this is a case where the function is a function of two other function. So in this case, how to solve or how to find out the derivative? So in this case, 5x square plus multiplied by 4, that is the derivative of del 4x plus 3, plus 4x plus 3 as constant and taking the derivative of 5x square. So if you are taking the derivative of 5x square, how much it will come? It will come as 10x. In the first case, we have to keep 5x square as the constant and we have to take the derivative of 4x plus 3, so which will come as 4. So the first case, fx is constant, the derivative is with respect to gx. Second, the gx is constant, the derivative is with respect to fx. So in this case, if you again simplify this, then this comes to 20x square plus 40x square plus 30x, so which come to 60x square plus 30x, okay. Now let's take another functional form, and where the function is again as a function of two other function. So it's a product of two other functions serve as a functional form for the independent variable where the value is defined by the independent variable. Now suppose take a numerical example where y is a function of x square plus 2x square, sorry, x cube plus 2x square plus 3. So this is one function and the other function is 2x square plus 5, okay. So there are two function over here. So taking the first order derivative del y by del x is equal to, so in this case the first one will be constant, now x cube plus 2x square plus 3 multiplied by the derivative of the second function. So the derivative of the second function is 4x. Similarly, now the second term टू एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फाइव विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट एंड वी हैव टू टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द फर्स्ट फंक्शन दैट इज थ्री एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस फोर एक्स. ओके सो सिंप्लीफाइंग दिस वी गेट फोर एक्स फोर प्लस एट एक्स क्यू प्लस ट्वेल्व एक्स फॉर द फर्स्ट वन. फॉर सेकेंड वन इट इज सिक्स एक्स फोर प्लस एट एक्स क्यू प्लस फाइव एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ट्वेंटी एक्स दैट कम्स टू टेन एक्स फोर प्लस सिक्सटीन एक्स क्यू प्लस फाइव एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस थर्टी टू एक्स. सो वेन द फंक्शनल फॉर्म इज ए प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू फंक्शन इन दैट केस बेसिकली वी टेक द डेरिवेटिव्स बाय कीपिंग द फर्स्ट फैक्टर फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज कॉन्स्टेंट एंड टेकिंग द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द सेकेंड फंक्शन एंड इन द सेकेंड केस वी कीप द सेकेंड फंक्शन इज द कॉन्स्टेंट एंड वी टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द फर्स्ट फंक्शन वेन द फंक्शनल फॉर्म इज प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू फंक्शंस. नेक्स्ट वील चेक हाउ वी जनरली सॉल्व और हाउ जनरली फाइंड द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ ए क्वेश्चन. सो हियर द फंक्शनल फॉर्म इज वाई इज ए फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स. ओके सो लेट्स राइट ए फंक्शनल फॉर्म. दिस इज जनरल फंक्शनल फॉर्म बट वेन यू टेक दैट दिस इज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ ए क्वेश्चन हियर द फंक्शनल फॉर्म इन्वॉल्व ए क्वेश्चन ऑफ टू फंक्शन दैट इज एफ एक्स एंड जी एक्स. इन दिस केस हाउ टू गेट द डेरिवेटिव वॉट इज द फॉर्मूला टू कैलकुलेट द डेरिवेटिव. सो डेल वाई बाई डेल एक्स इज इक्वल टू जी एक्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एफ एक्स विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू डेल एक्स. इन द फर्स्ट केस जी एक्स इज कॉन्स्टेंट द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द एफ एक्स एंड सेकेंड केस एफ एक्स इज कॉन्स्टेंट डेरिवेटिव ऑफ जी एक्स डिवाइडेड बाय जी एक्स टू द पावर होल स्क्वायर. ओके सो व्हेन द डेरिवेटिव इन्वॉल्व्स ए क्वेश्चन और द फंक्शन ऑफ ए क्वेश्चन टू फंक्शन ऑफ ए क्वेश्चन इन दिस केस द डेरिवेटिव इज डेरिवेटिव जनरली वी कैलकुलेट डेरिवेटिव बाय फॉलोइंग दिस फॉर्मूला दैट इज जी एक्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय डी डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एफ एक्स विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू एक्स. सेकेंड टर्म माइनस सेकेंड टर्म रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट एफ एक्स रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट वी टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ जी एक्स विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू डी एक्स एज ए होल दिस डिवाइडेड बाई जी एक्स टू द पावर इफ इट इज द होल स्क्वायर ऑफ दिस. नाउ लेट्स टेक ए फंक्शनल फॉर्म टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस इन ए न्यूमेरिकल टर्म. सो वाई इज ए फंक्शन ऑफ फाइव एक्स प्लस फोर एंड टू एक्स प्लस थ्री. ओके सो इन दिस केस हाउ विल गेट द डेरिवेटिव डेल वाई बाई डेल एक्स इज इक्वल टू टू एक्स प्लस थ्री. देन वी टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस दैट इज फाइव एक्स प्लस फोर दैट कम्स टू फाइव माइनस वी हैव टू कीप एफ एक्स एज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो फाइव एक्स प्लस फोर इज द कॉन्स्टेंट वी हैव टू टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ टू एक्स प्लस थ्री सो दैट कम्स टू टू एज ए होल टू एक्स प्लस थ्री whole square of this. So if you simplify this, this comes to 10x, okay, 10x plus 15 minus 10x plus 8 divided by 2x plus 3 square. So this is equal to 7 by 2x plus 3 square. So in case of a functional form, when there is it is a quotient of two function, in this case we generally follow a formula which keep one function constant by taking the other function derivative of the other function and finally it is divided by the functional form of the second function, sorry, the whole square of the second function is the divided by the whatever the derivative and the constant of the other two function. So now next we'll see the last category, that is when the function is a function of function, in that case how the derivative, how to find out the derivative. So we discuss about a power function, we discuss about a constant function, we discuss about a function which has sum and differences, we discuss about a function which has the product, and we discuss about a function which has in the quotient form. So now we'll discuss of a functional form which is function of a function. So now takes a functional form, y is a function of u and u is a function of x. Okay. So in this case, how to find out the derivative? Del y by del x is equal to del y by del u and del u by del x. So here the derivative has also two terms, one is del y by del u and second one is del u by del x. So let's take again a numerical functional form to understand this more. So y is equal to u cube plus 5u and u is equal to 2x square. So del y by del u is equal to 3u 3 minus 1 plus 5 and del u by del x is equal to, okay, so before finding this del u by del x, let's simplify it more, this del y by del u. So this comes to 3u square plus 5. Okay, now what is del y by del u? So u is equal to 2x square, as we know this is the functional form, u is equal to 2x square. So if you put this value over here, so then 3 2x square to the power again square plus 5, so which comes to 3 2x square again 2x square plus 5. Simplifying it further, so 3 multiplied by 2x square again multiplied by 2x square. So if you will simplify this again, so this comes to 12x4 plus 5. Okay, so this is what, this is our del y by del u. Okay, this is the first part of it. Now coming to the second part, second part is derivative of u with respect to x. Why the derivative is u, derivative of u with respect to x? Because the u is in a functional form and u is here the dependent variable, the value of the u depend on the value of the x. So taking the derivative of u with respect to x, we get 2 2x 2 minus 1, which is equal to 4x, because u is equal to 2x square. So del u by del x is 2 multiplied by 2x 2 minus 1, which comes to 4x. So now taking this del y by del x, which is again a function of del y by del u and del u by del x, so that comes to 12x to the power 4 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 4x, so this comes to 48x5 plus 20x. Okay, so what is happening over here? Here the functional form associated with the dependent variable has two function. It is a function of function. So the variable is directly not getting generated from the functional form, rather because the functional form is again a function of the other functional form. So in that case, generally we first find out the value of y, which is with respect to u. Then we find out the value of u with respect to x, and then finally we find the derivative of y with respect to x, which is a product of derivative of y with respect to u and derivative of u with respect to derivative of x. So taking the same example, it comes to 12x to the power 4 plus 5 multiplied by 4x, which come to 48x to the power 5 and 20x. So in this case, we discuss about a constant function, we discuss about a power function, we discuss about a function with sum and differences, we discuss about a function which has the product. We discuss about a function which has the quotient value. We discuss about a function where the function is again a function of some other variable. Now, let us analyze one more thing where the functional form has several independent variable. So, here we generally take a functional form where y is a function of x. Now, we will introduce a case where y, the value of y is not only getting valued in the form of the value of x, rather there are several other independent variable those who are deciding the value of y. We will take a value, we take a functional form with the multivariable, and then we will see how to find out, how to use the differential calculus or how to find out the derivative, the first order derivative, in order to understand the relationship between the independent variable and the dependent variable. So, in this case how the functional form will look like. So, let us take a case of a demand function, because in case of demand function the primary variable it affects demand is price. But if you look at, there are several other variables those who affect the demand for the product. So, we will take a case of a typical demand function where we assume that demand is not only influenced by the price, there are certain other variables also influence the demand, and we will see how we find out the relationship by taking the derivative with respect to different variable. So, here if you are taking it say a demand function, that is demand for x, it is dependent on price of x, dependent on price of the substitute good, dependent on the price of the complement goods, dependent on the income, dependent on the advertisement, and dependent on the taste of the consumer. So, here Px is the price of product, Ps is the price of substitute good, Pc is the price of complement good, Y is the income, A is the advertising expenditure, and T is the taste of the consumer. So, similarly there are some other function what gets used in economics typically, where the dependent variable is, dependent variables are dependent on many independent variable, not only one independent variable. So, this is one example is demand function. Similarly, there is also example of production function. So, if you take a production function, it is always a function of capital and labor. So, at least typically in the long run, the function is not only capital or the function is not only labor, rather it is a function of both capital and labor. So, if in this case if you consider Q is the output which is dependent on the capital and the labor, in this case the value of output dependent on two independent variable, that is value of capital and value of labor. Similarly, we can take a cost function where it is a function of capital, where it is a function of the rent what we pay for the capital, it is a function of the whatever the price we pay to the laborer, it is a function on the whatever the wages and the salary we are paying to the wages. So, in this case particularly when the functional form has many independent variable, in this case generally we use the partial differentiation, in order to understand the relationship between the two variable, that is x and y. Now, let us take a functional form. Okay. So, here y is a function of x cube plus 4x square plus 5z square. Okay. So, we have two variables here those are influencing y. Y is the dependent variable and x and z they are the independent variable. Okay. So, now how we will find the derivative or how we will establish the relationship between y and x and z. So, the first thing what we will do, we will find out the derivative with respect to x keeping the j, keeping the z constant. Okay. And in the second case, we will find out the derivative with respect to z keeping the x as the constant. We need to do a partial differentiation with each variable in order to understand their relationship with the dependent variable, and we cannot take the derivative of both the variables simultaneously, rather we will keep one as the constant and the derivative of the other as in order to understand the relationship. Now, taking the same functional form where y is a function of x cube plus 4x square plus 5z square, we will first find out del y with respect to del x. So, this will come as 3x 3 minus 1 plus 4z. Okay. Similarly, how we will find the second one, that is del y, and with respect to del z, which is 4x plus 2 5z 2 minus 1. So, this is 4x, okay, because z is constant. So, in this case we get 4x plus 2x 2 multiplied by 5z, that is 2 minus 1. So, that comes to 4x plus 10z. Similarly, if you take a functional form, suppose y is equal to ax to the power b and z to the power c. So, in this case, this is a case of your power function where the y is dependent on x and z. So, in this case, how we find the derivative? Derivative of y with respect to x, keeping the value of z constant, that is b a x b minus 1 z c, and second is del y and del z, keeping the value of x remain constant. So, that comes to a x b c z c minus 1. Okay. So, when you have a functional form which has many variables, and many variables particularly in the independent variable category, and where the dependent variable is dependent on many independent variable, in that case, in order to find out the derivatives, first we need to keep one variable constant, taking the derivative of y with respect to the other variable, and second case we need to keep the other variable as constant and taking the derivative of the y with respect to the present variable. So, with this we almost completed that what kind of derivative or how the derivative is used in case of different functional form, whether the functional form is the constant, it has the power function, or maybe it is addition, subtraction, product, quotient, or if it is a function of function. Okay.